I believe there should be a mandatory seminar when signing up for T-ball. I believe it should affect playing time when done wrongly to prevent a plague of losing. And most certainly, I believe passing a test should be involved when signing a national letter of intent or a professional contract. Heck, I think there should be a refresher course when handing out big league uniforms on opening day. Call it ethics, call it karma. Whatever you see it as, it's simple. Don't piss off the baseball gods. They're just too damn powerful. Now, the culture of the game is getting away from that nowadays and forgetting there are consequences. Celebrating too soon is the most common, especially in the postseason. This creates massive disasters. Let's not forget how social media can blow up in someone's face for talking too much smack before the job is done. The baseball gods have certainly kept up with technology for keeping everybody in check. Now, these things are the kiss of death. Unfortunately, they are widely accepted today, even encouraged, because someone pushed the notion that baseball is boring, and all the bored people jumped on the bandwagon. Now, of course, generation I need dopamine now started shredding the unwritten rules as to how to handle yourself as a ball player. Then the low-grade wonks in the media backed it up. Now, traditionally, results usually speak for themselves. Now, sadly, in this current state, the connections between transgressions and losing big games get swept under the rug. Now, very rarely do teams who win it all not handle themselves in the proper manner. The teams that hoist the trophy and get the big rings the following spring focus solely on winning. Talk is cheap. Ill-suited actions breed undesired results. The home run celebration insanity has gone well beyond being acceptable. Admiring the long ball and gaudy bat flips, they're one thing. Dancing around the bases are a whole other level of decadence. Don Drysdale is itching to be reincarnated. Now, all these cocky notions awaken the metaphysical spirits of those who are truly in charge of this great game. Sure, you can't prove it from a physical standpoint. Of course, in 2019, everything needs to have analytical data to prove it, even though most people cannot understand the analysis nor their significant meanings. Nonetheless, the repercussions are there. Look around. You want to play with fire? Get yourself to a burn center or denial therapy. If Ty Cobb is on the board of directors, that's one ghost that you don't want to piss off. And we know Mr. Ted has a hand and a very loud voice involved in the decision-making process. You've been warned. Do not wake him up. Now, I'm all for an athlete who can back up his claims in victory. It takes a bold player to succeed when he single-handedly raised the stakes. However, when you don't live up to the hype, you become the goat for a team, an organization, an entire city. And I'm not talking the LL Cool J standard. Now, you're taught in Little League not to clean up the equipment till the game is over, right? Well, the same concept goes for emotions and the things you say during a game. And the higher up this game goes, the more the respect factor tends to be magnified. Now, a few years ago, I watched an NCAA Super Regional game, and a recently drafted closer in the higher rounds came in to seal the victory in a one-run game. First batter, strikes out looking, big fist pump. Second batter, strikes out swinging, bigger fist pump, emotional release. Ha! Third batter, he gets the two strikes. Pitchers get amped. He's feeling it. He's showing it. Two-strike pitch, hanging slider, tie game. All that emotion, all for what? To hype up your team? It means nothing till you get the win, because that's when you celebrate. It can all be gone in a single heartbeat. Stay in the moment. Stay in command and play with respect. The outcome will take care of itself. And you never know when the baseball gods will cut you a break in a big way. Keep dominating, my friend. The baseball gods have a way to keep us all in check and weed out those who do not belong in this great game. And since you made it to the end of this video, the gods see something in you. And they want you to subscribe.